the lockdown situation, we are confined to the rooms and we hardly go out. And what we noticed when we went to Himalayas, up in the mountain region, very few people are wearing glasses, whereas in the city area, many children, small children also starts wearing the glasses from the right from small age, and they attribute that one to the building proximity. Buildings are so close to each other, we don't get an opportunity to gaze far away. And in Himalayan region, you can see through the panorama, it's miles together you can watch. You can see that one. And doing that one, it's your vision improves. If you are locked up at the in the house and confined to the room, your eyes becomes blurry. You get short-sighted or long-sighted easily. If you are not using your eyes for gazing at the far away distance, slowly eyes thinks, this memory in the eyes, I need not have to have that function. I need not have to look far away. That slowly diminishes. And use that, whatever is the usage is there, we get the benefit accordingly. Utilize properly, you will get the full extent. In yoga also, while doing the asanas, various asanas, twisting, turning, bending, forward bending, backward bending, many asanas we are doing, we are energizing the muscles and tissues. Otherwise, we would not use that one. When you are not using the muscles and tissues, they think, okay, I am not required, I am redundant. They go into hibernation. While doing the asana, when you are stretching your muscles and tissues, they come into action. They get energized. So is this, there are these eyes also. In the muscles, by doing that one, you get strength and flexibility improves. And because muscles are trained, are told that yes, you are required, you are not redundant. Come, be part of my life. So we are energizing through the asana, we are energizing all the muscles and tissues. We are not making them redundant, we want them to be part of our life. So are our eyes. We'll do the eye exercise. Well, sit straight. You are not moving your head. Without moving your head, now gaze at the right wall. Further, further, further. Forward. Look at the left wall without moving your head. Feel the stretch in the eyeballs. Feel the stretch further, further. Right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left. Look at the top wall, ceiling. Look at the ceiling without moving your head. Look at the floor near your feet. Up, down, up, down, up, down. Look at the right top corner. Remove your glasses if you are wearing. Down left bottom corner. Right top corner. Left bottom corner. Right top corner. Left bottom corner. Left top corner. Right bottom corner. Left top corner. Right bottom corner. Left top corner. Right bottom corner. Circling. Big circle. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Reverse. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And squeeze your eyes and open it wide. Squeeze. Open it wide. Squeeze. Open it wide. Bring your thumb in front. Look at the tip of the thumb. Bring it closer, closer, closer. Gaze at the tip of the thumb as if you are squinting, as if you are squinting. Further, further, further. Bring the tip of the thumb to the eyebrow center. Shambhavi Mudra. Now slide your tip of the thumb up. Further up, follow the tip of the thumb and back. With thumb and four fingers, massage, squeeze your eyebrows. Excess synovial fluid gets released. Massage the top of your eyeballs. Bottom part helps in improving the circulation around the eyes, eyelids. This bridge with the thumb and four fingers, press that bridge, press the corners, rub your palms together. Pass the warmth to the eyes, press the eyeballs, feel the warmth. And relax.